Hello, in this video I want to show how to create a motion study and give some tips about that. So here you have a robot that's moving across the wall, and it's in the meantime it's cleaning the wall with brushes. So that's not actually the robot that we want to create later on in this project, the project to create a cleaning robot, but it's just to give an idea of it. And I created the motion study in SOLIDWORKS to get an idea of the forces, etc., that are going to play a role in here. So you can see the robot moving slowly over here. I can change the speed and increase it a little bit. And in this video, I want to give them some tips how you can analyze this. So the robot is moving along a transparent wall. That's why you can still see it from the outside and the inside. And how I created this, how I created the force to stick this robot to the wall, is with help of an extra block that I put in the model. As you can see over here, it's an extra block, and within this extra block I created a spring in a motion analysis. So I can show the block and a spring over here. So at this moment I've hidden the block, I can show it, and then also show the spring that I created to attach the robot to the block. So this block is sliding across the cylindrical wall with zero friction, and then I enter a contact between the wall and the four wheels of the robot, and I found that to be the most robust way of actually creating contact within this simulation, so that it will still run pretty fast. And I create another simulation over here in which I enter the force that was going from the cylinder to the robot, and it didn't give that good results. As you can see over here, the robot moves and then suddenly falls off the wall. So now I could have go ahead and change all the settings of the contact. For example, change the material and change all the coefficients that I see over here. But in general, it doesn't yield very good results. So in most of the situation when contact doesn't work, it's better to start all over again and create another kind of simulation. And that's what I did with this block and the spring that you see over here. It just goes through the wall. It doesn't matter for SOLIDWORKS Motion. So to have SOLIDWORKS Motion, you need the SOLIDWORKS Premium, and then you can activate the add-in over here, SOLIDWORKS Motion, that can then analyze contact. And also after you've done the simulation, you can show results, like for example the forces. I'll show a plot of the force in this case in the Z and X direction. As you can see, it's a sinus, because when the robot is moving across the wall, and the X and the Z speed vary in the shape of a sinus. So I can show the other velocity plot over here as well. So that's nice. SOLIDWORKS Motion gives you the ability to plot forces and velocities and accelerations in all directions, which is very interesting to analyze a motion in your construction. Another thing that you need to do to analyze this motion in this case is to put the cleaning robot on flexible. As you can see the icon over here, it's set to a flexible subassembly, which means that it can move within the subassembly. And then to create the analysis, I just downloaded a robot from GapCraft. It's this one over here. As said previously, this is not the final robot that we want to create in this cleaning project, but it's just a robot to study the velocities, the forces, etc. And that's easy to analyze in SOLIDWORKS Motion Analysis. But the most important was how to create the contact when things aren't really working in other situations. Like in most cases, it's then the most convenient to start off fresh with a more simpler approach. And that's what I did in this case with the help of this block in the model. The block over here. So that was what I wanted to show in this video. Thanks for watching.